On that note, I'd like to introduce to the stage Stefan Galelli.
Thank you very much, Peter, for raising the level of expectation unduly. As you may have noticed, my field is competitiveness. And the great pleasure to be here is also the pleasure of being the last one to speak at the conference, almost the last one. And when you are the last one, it's always a very good news because everything intelligent has been said before you, so you can concentrate on the rest. I will deal with the rest being the world around us, because you will probably agree that one of the big problems we have is that probably our life would be a lot easier if the world would stop interfering with our strategy. The problem is that you define the best strategy in the world, and the world comes in, and the world is changing the rules of the game. What I would like to do is to share with you some ideas about the rules of the game today in terms of competitiveness, where we are going from there, and what are the consequences, trying to answer the question, so what? Taking it from what Paul Valéry used to say, he said, you know, the real trouble with our times is that the future is not what it used to be. And I think it's a very profound statement, because the future is not what it used to be. So we are going to see what it means. 20 years ago, when I started on competitiveness, you had nothing. You type on the Google search engine world competitiveness and you will find 21 million results. 21 million different definitions. Half of them I did myself. There is massive confusion on the market. So let me tell you what it is all about. The first thing, it's very simple. It's a wide-angle approach to economics. Remember when you were at university and they told you about economics, it was all about interest, budget, trade. It was immensely exciting. And now what we are doing is that we are looking at a wide-angle approach. We are looking at infrastructures, government, education, motivation, technology, all those kind of things we didn't learn, you know, at university, and that I think are very important for the success of a country or of a company. Now, when you are looking who is the most competitive athlete today, you probably would say it's Tiger Woods. And he's indeed highly competitive. Now, some of you may say Federer. I would agree, but being Swiss, I have to be neutral. Tiger Woods is the right guy because, you know, he earns $87 million last year, so he must do something good. Actually, he's playing golf very well. But playing golf is not enough. You need to have the right clubs, you have the right caddy, but especially you need to have the right mental approach, the right sense of purpose. Actually, competitiveness is managing a totality of competence. You are never competitive if you are good only at one thing. And I think this is one of the things we are going to look at together. But the big difference between golf and competitiveness is that in golf, you can win by one shot. While in competitiveness, the name of the game is the following. You are there, number one, obviously, otherwise you would not be there. And then you have all the others who are trying to catch up with you. And the name of the game is actually to maximize the difference between the others and yourself. You only make money in life if the distance between you and the others is bigger. And this is what we are going to see. The smaller the distance, the less money you are doing. The bigger, the more money you do. And therefore, you have two drivers in competitiveness. Number one is the management of efficiency. We are all supposed to deliver the good, profit. The second thing is the management of change. We are supposed to manage change. And when you think about it, this is what we do all day long. Efficiency, change. The real fundamental question we all have is the following. Is it the same people that can do both? Because when you are very efficient, you are very successful, and when you are very successful, you don't want to change. And this is a challenge. How do you have successful people change? And this is one of the nightmares of modern management, and we are going to see what it means. Because change is everywhere. I told you about the wide-angle approach. Biology gives us a lot of ideas. If you look at your body, you will find that all your body cells are entirely renewed every 3 years. Every 3 years, all your cells are renewed. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very good news. Because it means the following. If you have made a mistake more than 3 years ago, you are not responsible anymore. It was somebody else. Don't abuse it too much, however. It's about qualitative change. If you take the Neanderthal man, he had a brain of 1,600 cubic centimeters. Is our brain bigger or smaller? Actually, yes, it's smaller. We have a smaller brain. Are we more or less intelligent? That's another story. But we have a smaller brain. Very interesting. And finally, for this short introduction on competitiveness, a very nice relationship which was done and discovered between competitive